negative trend,
and working on a memoir.
So come on up here right now, Rozz Rezabek.
Hi, everybody. I've never done one of these kind of reading events before. But everybody says, oh, Rozz, you got some good stories. First time I came down to San Francisco was as a runaway. Don't do it, son. To be a punk rocker in 1977. And I heard the guy before me talking about, like, really terrible bands. I am the documented worst ever punk singer. No, I'm serious. Read the GIMME SOMETHING BETTER book. The Sex Pistols came to town. Malcolm McLaren came to Howie Klein. He says, Howie, what's the fucking worst band in San Francisco? He says, oh, hands down, it's Negative Trend. The singer can't sing, the bass player can't play, and the guitar player's always out of tune. So Howie, are they really that god-awful? Howie says, they're the worst fucking band in the world. So Malcolm McLaren, having a little light bulb go off in his head, goes, ah, okay, well, we're not playing at Winterland unless the Negative Trend plays with us. So for 30 years, I thought Malcolm McLaren saw something in me. Was that we sucked. And we did suck. And the worst thing about sucking is I was right on that cusp. I came down here with three strippers. A couple of them did porn. Never came back to bite them in the ass. No VHS, nothing. Me, I just put both legs behind my head and cut a fart into the microphone. Boom! Negative Trend on YouTube. I got a 25-year-old Italian girlfriend. She goes, oh, I just saw the most lovely video of you on YouTube. You put both legs behind your head and fart in microphone. Once again, son, don't do it. But my son's down here with me, not really for good reason, because he got, like, suspended from school. 15 times! And we're going up, and luckily music has afforded me a lawyer. Because this girl came out of Montana and we slept together, and then she slept with a guy in the Dandy Warhols, and then she dumped him for Sean Lennon, John Lennon's son. And the guy from the Dandy Warhols calls me and says, hey, what's that one song you did, Val Yum 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 or Valium something? And at that point, there was no competition because we were both just two guys that had been dumped by a model. And that's fairly fucking common. So they recorded one of my songs, which allows me to have money to do things like this, because I get money once in a while for a song I wrote 25 years ago about a drug that nobody takes anymore. Now everybody takes Xanax because it's got a cooler name. Same damn drug. So this is notes for my speech. I've never really spoken before in public. I have sang. I've been on YouTube farting with both legs behind my head, all in the name of punk rock, or what my mother calls this craziness. My mother could never even utter the words punk rock. Mom could not say the words punk rock, so she would just say, honey, when are you gonna give up this craziness and get a job? This craziness is no good. They always end up unhappy. Just look at that Presley fella. And I says, you mean Elvis, Mom? She goes, that Presley fella, you know who I mean. Because my mom is Czech. As you can tell from my name, I'm a Czechoslovakian too. She just could not say the words punk rock. And I want to tell everybody, if you didn't know, you know that term tough love? The term tough love was coined by a group called Parents of Punkers. That was like a parents, let's fight back kind of deal back in the mid-70s. Well, late 70s, whenever punk rock was. So anyway, I came down here, I was 17 years old. I came down here and started this band, Negative Trend, with these guys who'd been in a band with Don Vinyl. And it was a very fast life. It was like too fast of a life. One of the things that I'm most famous for, I keep getting these 15 minutes of fame that just keep coming biting me in the butt, and I really didn't do anything to earn them, but one of them was at an Avengers show. I know Penelope's here tonight. It was at an Avengers party, though. It was at an Avengers party at GIMME Studios. I tripped over a microphone cord, and I broke my arm. And I went to the hospital, and they said, hey, you've got a broken arm. And they wrapped it in a splint and said, now go sit over there and wait for a cast. I was like, wait for a cast? Fucking the Avengers and the Dills are opening for Crime. I don't want to go see Crime. I want to go see the Avengers and the Dills. So I left the hospital without waiting for a cast. And now I have to explain this to my doctor when they start removing the tumors that showed up on my arms here now that I'm a 50-year-old fucker. So I'm saying, my doctor says, well, why didn't you wait for the cast? And I'm like, well, I don't know. We were all just in a hurry. It was like what we were doing with our lives or whatever. And I really have no good explanation. I mean, have any of you ever broken an arm or a leg or anything? Yeah. Did you go to the hospital? Did you wait for the cast? See, I didn't wait for the cast. I decided, nah! Punk rock! Woo! This craziness! I'm not waiting for no cast. I'm going to the Mabube. So then the second time I broke my arm, oh, believe me, there was plenty of arm breakings and bottles breaking my face and everything else. I got a cast, and then the third time we played, I jumped off the stage and broke the cast. And then the fourth time we played, the wonderful YouTube video was shot with me, of course, putting both legs behind my head, which I could not do today. I could maybe get one back there and farting into the microphone. But what people don't know that you kind of see but you don't see in that YouTube video of Negative Trend that's been going around, is that night, it was so fucking crazy. Negative Trend, like, was an anarchistic, whatever, I don't know what we were crazy. And we attracted more troubled loners and weirdos than any other band. So that night, while I'm like on stage, this guy comes up and I'm just doing my thing, sticking my legs behind my head, cutting a fart in the microphone, and not thinking nothing of it, and then my eyes are stinging all of a sudden. Well, this guy had brought a squirt gun that he'd filled full of flammable liquid, and he is spraying me with gasoline, and he was trying to light me on fire when Dirk and Rabbit, who's dead now, God rest his soul, they came up, and so is Dirk. You're right. I can't accept that. So I'm in denial on Dirk. Dirk was a mentor of mine. Dirk was the guy, well, actually, Penelope was the first one I called. I got arrested and went to jail for having tetracycline for my acne back then. I got popped by the cops, they take me to jail, and they think I have drugs on me, and I say, no, those are for my pimples. That's acne medicine. Yeah, it looks like drugs to me. So, boom, they throw me in jail. I didn't know any phone numbers. I'm from Portland. I come down here. I'm some hayseed. But I met Penelope the one time, and I thought of, she gave me her number, and I thought of calling her about 500 times. But I never did, but I memorized the number. And when I went to jail that night and got reminded that even though I was a tough punk rocker who'd broken my arm several times on stage, I was still just had barely turned 18, and I was scared to fucking death. And the only phone number I could remember was Penelope. And I called Penelope, and she was so good. She got a hold of Dirk and everybody, and they got things straightened out. I got the charges dropped. Apparently it's not against the law to carry tetracycline. But I took my son, who's now getting pimples of his own. They're hereditary, asshole. I took him to the doctor and I said, like, hey, can you give him some tetracycline or something? They went, tetracycline? What the hell, are you in like a time warp? Nobody prescribes that anymore. Tetracycline, that's what makes your teeth bad and your immune system shot. And I'm like, wow, worked okay for me, but then all that stuff from back there worked for me. I don't know how my time is. I hear the music. Does that mean it's time to go?
What about the guy that tried to set you on fire?
Well, the guy that tried to set me on fire, he's not getting invited to this thing.